Hey everyone, my name is Austin Lee and I am an expert in fraud prevention. I'll be talking to you today about synthetic identity fraud, what it is and how to prevent it. So a little background about myself. I have been at various different banks such as Bank of America, Citibank, and been in cybersecurity fraud prevention roles specializing in data analytics and data science. So I can say that I understand the data, I understand how the synthetic identities are created, and a few preventative measures for you as an investigator, a data analyst, a data scientist to help prevent that. So let's dive in. I think it's important to break down one important key piece in synthetic identity fraud. Typical fraud is what you would call third-party fraud. And in third-party fraud, you are the victim. So if somebody steals your credit card, if they take over your account, they scam you out of money, you become the victim of that fraud attack. Where first party fraud and synthetic identity is a little bit different. With synthetic identity, it's a fictitious identity, either completely fictitious, or it's mingled together from different attributes of real people. And in that instance, the bank is the victim. So that's why they call it first party fraud for synthetic identities. Now, how a synthetic identity is created is a little complex because it can happen in a few different ways. One is called piggybacking. So when you get on a credit card as an authorized user, due to the Fair Credit Reporting Act, you gain that access to the credit line. So for example, let's say somebody's 25 years old and they get on their mom's Discover $15,000 credit line, which is now 30 years old. If you're an authorized user, you actually get that credit card on your credit bureau report. So in the credit bureau report, even though you're 25, now you have a 30-year-old credit line with $15,000 with 100% on-time payments. Now your credit score goes rapidly up. And in that particular instance, that person now exists as a real human being in the credit bureau reporting agencies. So another example of how a fictitious account might be made is they start to take different real attributes of real people. So for example, they could take address, social security number, phone number, things like that to piecemeal together a Frankenstein identity in that synthetic identity perpetrator. And what happens here is that it looks like there's enough information about that particular person for them to be real. So in these two instances, they're a little bit different and they can be very, very complex in how they evolve because it's a slow rolling fraud. Typically banks, 95% of banks don't catch synthetic identity through the credit card application process, which is huge. And a lot of times people don't realize that those are synthetic identities until the individual, what they call busts out or spends their limit on their credit card. And the other point with that is these are hard to tell if they are just somebody who didn't pay their credit card. So to dive in a little bit deeper on three different ways to look and capture synthetic identity fraud. One is getting a 360 view. So having a tool that can help you detect identifiers, whether they're shared address, shared device with login activity, things like that, that will help you understand if this is a real person, because it doesn't make sense for an individual to have multiple different identities using the same device. For analysts and data scientists, it's really important to gather credit bureau information and credit bureau data. And again, using the graphical link, you can start to detect and find high risk synthetic identity fraud. And now that's important because using credit bureau data, you need information that isn't just at your financial institution. You need to go a little bit further and see if that individual has bust out at other previous banks. And you can tell that you might be next with that particular ring. And then the third piece is just fraudulent connections. This one seems very simple, but it's really hard to detect if you're just looking at this person at their own credit bureau profile. You're looking at their possible LexisNexis account. You're looking at all of their identity information. But if they're connected to a fraudulent or multiple fraudulent accounts by address or device or things like that, those become suspicious identifiers and allow you to navigate your investigation with ease and determine if this person is synthetic. So thank you for joining me on my quick and first topic about fraud. I'm excited to do a few more of these. Feel free to comment about what you would like to see and information you'd like to have and what you're seeing at your bank or your company to navigate the fraud landscape together. Thank you so much.